In this video, I will show you how to calculate total years of experience or employee service tenure in years, months, and days using the date of joining in Excel like this. So let's get started. Here, I have an Excel sheet containing employee names and their date of joining and date of leaving in separate columns. Now, I want to calculate the total experience or job tenure of each employee in years, months, and days using these two dates. To do that, I'm going to use the DateDiff Excel function. The DateDiff function is used to calculate the difference between two dates in years, months, or days. We need to provide three arguments to the DateDiff function: start date, end date, and the unit in which we want the date difference. Let's select the cell where we want the tenure to appear and type an equal sign to start the formula. Now type DateDiff and an opening bracket. Now select the cell containing the date of joining as the start date and type a comma. Select the cell containing the date of leaving as the end date and enter a comma. Type Y as the third argument to calculate the difference in years, and then type the closing bracket. Now type the ampersand sign and type years to open the years text at the end. Hit the enter key to complete the formula. As you can see, we now have service tenure in years. Let's edit the formula to include the months as well by double clicking the cell. Type the ampersand sign and then type the DateDiff function with the same start and end dates but with YM as unit argument. The YM unit argument calculates the difference in months. It ignores the days and years of the dates. Append the months text at the end and hit the enter key. We now have years of experience in years and months. To include the days, we are going to follow the same process but use the MD as the unit argument in the DateDiff function. The MD argument calculates the difference in days between two dates and ignores years and months. As you can see, we now have total years of experience in years, months, and days. If you want job tenure in years only, you can use this formula. Similarly, we can also calculate the job tenure in months only using this formula. Please note that I have used M as the unit argument, not YM, to calculate the number of complete months between two dates. Finally, use this formula to calculate the job tenure in days. Here, use the D argument as the unit instead of MD to calculate the difference in days. If you want to calculate the years of experience as of today's date instead of using the date of leaving, that can be done very easily. We just need to replace the cell reference of the date of leaving column with the today function like this. One benefit of using the today function is that whenever we open the Excel file, we will always have up-to-date tenure calculations. Watch this video to learn how to remove all the data from an Excel sheet but keep the formulas. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.